In this proof of concept video, a specific kind of fault injection attack is demonstrated against a vulnerable microcontroller. The principal idea of fault injection attacks is to provoke unintended behavior in a tested system, resulting in an incorrect or faulty operation, which is beneficial for an attacker. The physical fault injection attack demonstrated in this video exploits a side channel available in all electronic devices, the voltage supply. By manipulating the voltage supply of a microcontroller in a targeted way, by introducing controlled glitches, it may be possible to change its behavior, for example, the result of performed read or write memory operations. This circumstance can be exploited, for example, to bypass implemented security measures such as read-out or read-back protection for a microcontroller's internal memory, preventing unauthorized access to the device firmware or sensitive data like cryptographic keys. In this video, our IT security expert, Dr. Matthias Kesenheimer, demonstrates how the read-out protection of an nRF52832 can be bypassed using a voltage glitching attack. This microcontroller by Nordic Semiconductor is, for example, used in Apple AirTags or some wireless Logitech keyboards. How to successfully attack this microcontroller's readback protection is not new and has been demonstrated many times by different researchers in the last few years. This nRF52 microcontroller became a useful target device for testing a voltage glitching setup. For performing the voltage glitching attack in this video, a ChipWhisperer Pro with a UFO target board is used. The Apple AirTag with the targeted nRF microcontroller was placed on a separate breakout board, which was connected to the ChipWhisperer Pro and a Sega J-Link debugging probe. Matthias Kesenheimer developed Python code in a Jupyter notebook for configuring the ChipWhisperer Pro and executing this voltage glitching attack. The glitches in the voltage supply were monitored using an oscilloscope. A little more than half an hour later, a successful glitch was triggered that allowed to access the serial wire debug interface of the nRF microcontroller. Using OpenOCD, it was then possible to dump the memory content of the microcontroller as the enabled readback protection was successfully bypassed. Attackers could now analyze the dumped memory content and also write modified data back to the microcontroller if they wanted to.